What's going on, guys? It's Radar here with round two of the V8 Supercar Series official. Here we are at Donington Park. We've got 24 laps. This is the main Monday night race. The session starts at 9:15, but with the new quality format, it's really 9:30. So we've qualified 7th, car number 10. We've only just pipped Marty Carroll by 0.001 of a second. So here we go. This race should hopefully go better than the last one. I blew my engine at about turn 5, just a simple down change from 4th to 5th, 3rd to 4th, 4th to 3rd on lap 1. So hopefully this engine they put in the car now is a bit stronger than the last one. So sitting here waiting for the green flag. It's a sprint race, 80 litres of fuel,
Michael.
24 laps, enjoy. Bogged it down. Last race I passed 3 cars off the line, so Mitch is blinking.
You got one on your left. Stay right. Hold your line. You got one on your left. Right there. Right there. All clear, all clear.
Oh, missed that turning point. So coming up to where I blew my engine in the first race tonight. Let's see if it lasts longer. Oh, we've already gone further than the first race. Yay. If you had turned it any later, I would have sent it, but
you're on your way. Keep right there. All clear, all clear.
Marty can be a bit dangerous sometimes, so we'll let him go. Why are they breaking so open to him? I do not know. No, I'm not as strong through this last part of the lap. Just for some reason with the setup, it's really good through the flowing corners, but not through these ones. Really gotta get that chicane right. Some guys use first gear, but in the race at least, I'll go with the peace of mind of second gear. They're tight enough to use first, but especially off that last lap, a little bump right where you want to put the power down, so keep it in second just for security. A slowdown. I didn't think that was enough curb to warrant a slowdown, but we'll serve it on the back straight. It's easier to do it there. Clear, 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 come on, clear. pass to get back to where we want to be. Now, I don't really care about how we're doing these races because I don't really care about official series anymore. I mean, it's more premier series I'd rather do well in. Only racing official just to keep laps up in the V8 for Premier Series because there's been a massive gap between round 2 and 3. Bad frame drop on the front straight there. Basically got no pressure from behind now. Come on, stop and get at the corner, will ya? This could be risky, but we're gonna do it anyway with that brake bias change. Come on, turn at the corner. Thank you. Got through it without an incident. Bit of a train here. Cars not turning now, we're going back to first. Just got to use throttle control now. I hate this track, really, I do. Stop. Why is it lagging all of a sudden? It's been doing this not at all in practice, and now I'm getting frames lag. Made up a position. See how I slow down too, so I'll drop a little bit back to clear that. pit lane complex causes all that lag. It's painful for you watching, it's painful for me driving too. Stopped and turned for that corner, especially. I haven't run a bit more front brake this week than I usually would, simply just because the rears just don't want to just lock all the time. I tried to dial out of the setup, but none of my tricks would work, so I just went more front brake bias, and that lessens the effect. Get stopped. I won't stop anymore. Good news is we've still got rear grip, which I thought we wouldn't have any of at this stage now. Considering the track's really hot, it's 40 degrees track temp, which is hot for iRacing. The iRacing tyres tend to like colder temperatures than at least in the VA. You can get some good pace out of cold tracks. That's what I was talking about with all that rear brake. It just doesn't like stopping. At this stage I'm waiting for a mistake up there to gain a position. Stop sliding in the rear. Terrible drive right now. Very much disliking it. Oh, being double shifted. Seems to disconnect at that right hander after the downhill section. It's just not where I want it. Terrible hairpin. That was terrible. That's the only word I can use to describe it. We have made some ground up on Marcelo though. That's better. Stay where I want it. Wasn't catching the rear at turning, which is exactly what I wanted in that corner. It's good for going that time. Thanks, man. So 5/10 that lap we pull in. We are pulling Marcelo in. Chris is just tagging along behind us. Thank you. thought it was a car for position, but it's just lap traffic. Kind of holding station with Marcelo now, I must just have a few bad laps there. That bump. Oh well, we'll get it served up here. She's gonna make our job to get to Marcelo a little bit harder. I get on the car, but I can't quite get it. Oh, well, I couldn't be bothered getting rid of it, basically. Whoa, 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 whoa! That's not what you're supposed to do when I go to first gear. That was interesting. Turned into a drift car there for a sec. Good, not bad. That, yeah, this is not a good lap. Not a good lap at all. That's stupid. Slow down for that, yeah. That was an awkward bounce. Very awkward bounce. Thumbs up, it's not working properly. See, that wasn't happening the entire race, now it is. At least we're beating Corey Crash Preston. That's good. The day I lose a straight fight to Corey Preston is the day I will retire from iRacing. Braked way too early. Stop doing that. It's not like it's a hard downshift to first gear. So many cars in pit lane, so much lag. For those of you who weren't aware, yesterday was the Sebring 12 Hours. So myself, Jake Burton, Kurt Stenberg put in a prototype for that. Made top split, put 7th on the grid, and then at the end of the 12 hours we were on the podium. We put in 3rd place, so it was a long, long night for me. I stayed up for the start, which was midnight my time. For the two guys I was driving with, WA time was 9 p.m. for them. So I was up at 12, I stayed awake till 12, watched the start, tried to go to sleep after that, couldn't, and I'm going to overshoot this because I missed my braking mode. I'm over this race. Just finished already. Where was I? Sebring 12 hour. After this corner. After this set of course, I'll get back to that. Oop, I saw that man mistake. So I had the graveyard hours for the Sebring 12 hour. I was in the car from 4 a.m. to 9 a.m. So I did five hours in the car, 5 stints. Took it off Stenberg in 7th place, and then my 5 hours. Come on, stop. We're up in 5th, so. And then just some fuel. I'm like, okay, once my stint's done, I'm gonna probably go to bed and can't wake up for the finish. Nope, I didn't leave. I just went and had a shower, had breakfast at 9 a.m. in the morning. Came back and sat there with Jake and acted as crew chief and did bulk fuel numbers towards the end of the race to eventually know. It meant that we only had to stop one more time in the last hour. Guys ahead of us had to pit about twice more, so one of the cars had an incident with GT cars, so we gained a place from that, and then we were racing for 3rd, and they had to fuel save, and we were able to go all out, so we ended up putting it in 3rd place. We made that pass for about 15 minutes to go, so it's pretty comfortable in the end. Yeah, I had definitely flying the Australian flag in that one, as well as STC Motorsports. They put it in second in top split.
Yeah, they were freaks. They were a whole lap ahead of us. Radicals won up by 2 laps, and STC were a lap ahead of us.
I think we won most unprepared team award as well. We got the setup down 3 hours before the race. If you want to catch that again, what Race Spot TV on YouTube, they have the full 12 hours now up. So you can watch that if you want. Definitely watch the last hour. And I've missed my braking point again. That last hour was basically our car and Team Tordo's car, which was driven by a Deco driver, so it was all Deco for the race. Go away! Oh. Note to self, never race Donington in the V8 again. It is the world's worst track. It does not suit the V8 supercar. I know it's a touring car track, but it does not suit this car. Nor does that Mosport piece of junk that they produced in last year. Last week. It's great to start Mazda, but nah, cut it away in the V8. That's not. That's a prototype / GT track. You need something with a little wing, a bit of downforce to do that track. Next week's even better. Going to the world's longest oval with chicane, Monza. I might drive that, just because it's a new track. It's not like it's a hard track anyway. Go fast, stop. Go fast, stop. That's all you have to do. And then turn left and right really quickly.
Keep pushing, man. Keep pushing. Boys, some very, very, very slow.
Yeah, cheers for that, mate. You know this on all teams. I know how to upgrade a radio. How many more laps? It's 3 laps to me.
Good work, bud.
You're on all teams, mate. He obviously didn't get the message the first time. Even though all my terrible driving, still maintaining the gap to these two. The next round of Premier Series is Oran Park on April 12th. So the 9th, the 10th, and the 11th will be pre-qual, and the 12th is the race. So hopefully we have as good a round. We qualified great for Montreal, and stop, damn it! We had a great qualifying in Montreal, you know, put it in third place, just casually doing that. But then the race, we got messed around with some slowdowns, and then just to top it off, the old internet decided to drop. Otherwise, we're on for a top 10 easily. Unfortunately, after the race, we had the pace to win that race, so things happened, but Oran Park. Definitely a strong track, especially for Jake. Very, very strong for him. He keeps telling me it's strong, so I'm going to take it that it's a strong track for him. I'll be able to catch all that on V8 online, and maybe, if I feel like it, I might record that one. You will be getting teammates talking in the background, so if you want that, let me know in the comments if you don't. I just won't record Premier races. I would like to. I don't think anyone does, and it gives you an insight into what it's like to actually be in a Prem Series race. But yeah, if you don't want to hear teammates talking or team speaking and all that sort of stuff, I won't record it, but if you don't mind, I'll do it. Just for at least get around and see whether it catches on.
Oh, did Corey fence it? I think Corey fenced it. He's not on my relative thread anymore. Corey crashed. Preston has struck. He has found the nearest wall and hit it very hard. Or he just spun. Either way. This has undoubtedly been probably one of the most sloppiest races I've ever driven in this car since I first started to drive it over a year ago now. Almost 2 years actually since I started driving this car. This is undoubtedly the worst race I've ever driven. Yes, I'm finishing the top 10 in a soft race, but yeah, terrible. That's all. I'm great with my vocabulary. I've got like one word to describe bad things. It's terrible. Oh, we got a sniff. We have a sniff. Send it. I'm gonna send it from this far back. We'll just shortcut the track. Take the right left instead of the left right, yeah? That's how you do it. Something wrong with these two. Maybe they didn't put enough fuel in. Drift car. That's weird, I pulled in a second that lap, and I'm still pulling in. Nah, not gonna happen. Oh well. 10th place.
I ran Ian, Ethan, Mitch.
In a race I did not really prepare for.
Good race in the first one, don't you think?
I didn't think I was gonna race it until tonight. I'm like, yeah, why not? Need something to do. So thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed watching me drive terribly, and I'll catch you on the flip side.
Quite a good race in there.